This will be a video showcasing some of my results trying to photograph the PERSEIDS meteor shower. I think this is something truly special and I want to share it with you all. This is not my first time imaging the night sky and the Milky Way. However, this time the focus was, well, getting the Milky Way in frame, trying to get lucky and capture some meteors passing by. So let's get started. Before the night sky came alive, let me tell you about the location we've chosen. Of course, we needed a relatively remote site with clear skies and a lot of nothingness, and this is where we chose. It's called Alfândega de Fei, and it's situated far northeast in Portugal, where I live. It has a dry and tranquil atmosphere and was the perfect setting for this. We also searched for a high spot to get the best clarity. As the night arrives, I set up my trusty DSLR, which is a simple Canon EOS 700, attaching a small and sturdy tripod and changing the settings. Every detail had to be just right, from the camera settings to the positioning, to capture the meteor's splendor. This is how I adjusted the configurations, but this might change based on your personal preference, gear, and sky conditions. First, the images should be saved as RAW. This is very important, and you can also save as JPEG if you want. I kept the ISO at 1600, the white balance to the day mode, and the shutter to bulb. Also, it's very important to use a remote shutter controller in order to program a large amount of frames to be taken automatically without touching the hardware. On the remote controller, I've set it to take a huge amount of frames, even though I stop it manually after around 70 to 100 with 20 seconds of exposure each and a 5-second interval between each photo. The objective is to take a large amount of single photos of 20 seconds. This can vary, and then stack them all during post-processing to get the best result. More on that later. As darkness spread across the canvas of the sky, stars started to twinkle, setting the stage for an extraordinary celestial show. Now, it was time to make myself comfortable and grab some snacks. This year's PERSEIDS meteor shower was great since it was during the hot days of summer and the moon's light was practically insignificant. However, it was still nice to look at. Capturing these meteors was a delicate mixture of art and technology. Since my lens was not very wide in range of field of view, it was tricky to get many meteors. However, I managed to get a good amount and those could be checked in individual frames. Now, to process the photos, I divided each sequence of photos to be stacked and pretty much did the same thing to each. First, I imported them to a dedicated frame stacking software. I used Sequator for its simplicity. But if you want to go hardcore, I recommend Deep Sky Stacker. The process is simple. Import the sequence, choose the main frame, and tweak the settings. I always choose to fix the ground and only align and stack the sky region of the sky. For that, you might have to do a delicate selection of the part of the images that correspond to the sky. Next step was to save the result and then use an editing software to adjust the image levels. You can use Photoshop, for example, or Adobe Lightroom. And now, let's take a step back in time and relive those moments. These are the results. The PERSEIDS meteor shower is one of the best, and for me personally, the best meteor shower since it happens during the summer. And you can watch multiple meteors each minute that passes. Well, if the sky is really dark, being there under the canopy of stars, capturing the PERSEIDS meteor shower, it is always a humbling experience. Nights like these remind us of the beauty and mysteries that lie beyond our world. Thank you for watching. If this video ignited your curiosity, don't forget to check out my channel, and since I don't post very frequently, feel free to subscribe without being constantly spammed with content. Until next time, keep gazing at the stars.